All right, guys, I have something a little bit different and something very special for you today. In this video, I'm going to be showing you how to play Akali like a pro. This is going to cover everything from runes to items. Guys, I'm doing a $1,000 RP giveaway with a bunch of YouTubers. To enter, all you got to do is click the link in the description. Anyone can win from anywhere across the world. Good luck. To early, mid, late game, how to snowball, how to get kills, how to carry, and literally everything you could ever need to know on Akali. And within 10 minutes, you guys are going to be much better players at Akali. So hope you guys are ready to destroy everything in ranked with this secretly OP champion. Let's just get right into it. So starting off with the runes, or should we talk about this since it's a commentary as well? Nice poke. Guys, alright, so let's talk about the runes first. So Conquer is the best rune page now against melee champions. Electrocute is a little bit weaker now since you can't really Q auto Q in lane. Oh, that's brutal. He actually hooked me into the tower. I'm just not used to playing against Pyke that much. But yeah, we are going against a melee, so Conquer is the way. And this is the best rune page for solo queue. Anyways, the way you want to play Akali, guys, is literally play aggressive in melee matchups. But versus range matchups, literally just try your best to hit 6 without having any problems. Get as much gold as possible. Because once you hit 6, it is the first key to winning the game. There are a few keys. Use a potion now, should be fine. Use a Q to get a little bit of a movement speed buff. And also Q with the tip of my Q for a slow. And we're completely fine. But as I was mentioning, guys, all you gotta do is hit level 6 and then great things will happen. Oh, he actually eat out. Okay. I thought he was gonna dodge and then try to fight. Obviously, don't be afraid to take trades, because if you're ever playing top lane or if you're ever going into melee champion, you need to learn how to trade them, because you can actually get early kills with Akali. You can actually force them to go back, which gives you an early lead with Akali. There's really no reason to not at least try. Wow. How did that hit? Anyways, I'm gonna continue playing aggressive now. Don't even try it. You know what's funny? I'm so confident in my Akali and the strategy that I'm gonna keep going. So you can even carry when you're down one kill on Akali. Just hit 6 and you will win. Trust me. So we're back in the lane. It is starting to push a little bit. So we are gonna just press Q, press W, get this whole wave shoved in really quick. Because we do want the wave to crash. Wave is going to crash and then it's going to reset. But we have a little bit of time. Look for the jungler. Maybe see if we can steal Skull Crab. Maybe go for a gank. Right now, it's looking possible. Oh yeah, definitely looking possible. There is a pink ward though. Didn't end up getting anything. Completely fine. Always just at least try. We lose one minion in CS, but it doesn't matter. Now, we don't have E. We don't have Flash. You need to make sure you always save at least one thing for escape, which right now it's gonna be our shroud. Not gonna be using it to go aggressive or anything. We got level 6, our wave is pushed, so we're literally just gonna go straight top lane. And what you wanna do when you're roaming top lane for mid is check one brush, ward the other, just to make sure you're not wasting your time, because if it's warded, then we're dead. Oh god. Okay, well. Anyways, guys, at this point, melee versus melee, we just need a little bit of room to kill Pyke, so we wanna actually freeze the wave towards our tower. He pushed a little bit too much. And now I can kind of work with that and just make it so I have way less minions than him, but not enough to the point where it's going to hurt my health bar too much. Right now it's like not doing much, and if he wants to try and farm since he's melee versus melee, he's going to have to overextend a ton. Uh-oh. We're good. And I'm going to keep this freeze. Even though I saw Pyke top, he's more than likely than not on his way back, and I don't push instantly because I'm only level 7 and I don't have a bunch of AP. So we're actually going to keep the wave frozen a little bit towards our tower. It's only a tiny bit now. And now I see Pyke still fighting. I am going to push. Since this time it is very easy to push. And he's going to run all the way. He's going to miss a ton of XP, a ton of CS. So even though he gets that kill, it actually... Well, look how ahead we are on CS. And it's only going to get crazier in like a second. Go ahead and push this all. I'm gonna back up and then we're gonna go ahead and just go straight to bot lane. See if there's a pink ward in sight. Hopefully there's no pink there. I don't have time to like check all of them. Right now they're pushed. It looks like there actually might have been. Yep, there was. You can tell just off the way they path. So we clear it out and we head back to mid. Honestly, we are playing against maybe the most passive Pyke I've ever seen in my entire life. So with that in mind, we're gonna take the quick recall, get a bilge water and some more AP. This will help us slow him and actually get the kill and What do you know? The Nami going for the 1v3. Does not get the 1v3 as the support. That's level 6 versus level 8 fed players. Okay. Anyways, it's just something that's going to happen a lot in your solo queue games. You just have to deal with it. It's not a big deal. Just try your best. And this is actually really good. Should be able to just not. I don't think I need to flash it. Perfect. Don't want to flash if you don't have to. I saw Nami did get rid of Zach's passive. So with that in mind, no need to really do anything else. And guys, this is the beginning of the end. This is truly it. It doesn't matter if you're 0 and 1 because something happens. Your ult, you make a play, they stay overextend. It just takes one little thing, one little snowball. It turns into 2 kills, turns into 2 plates. That's 3 kills worth of gold. That's all this extra XP that he doesn't have. Now we're going to go ahead and push this in really quick. And then E and leave. And as you guys could see right there, I was on the other side of the minion, but if I E, it flies you backwards and then it shoots it out. So you can actually clear the wave and run away at the same time to go back. A little pro tip, sometimes actually really useful. But moving on, we have the next item. We're going for Zhonya's next because they have almost all AD. Armor is very good against a bunch of AD champions. They don't really have an AP. Zac is kind of a tank. Guys, just look at this. This is another golden opportunity for us to get ahead. If Pyke... I think I can kill him. I don't want him to... I don't want to like waste any time. If I Q while I'm further away, then auto when I'm in range to auto, it's just the fastest way. I didn't want him to channel his E and then run. That could have been really good. Didn't hit. Guys, we're going to keep going. I think this is a double execute potentially. Nope, nope, nope. We got it. Don't even. Alright, that's fine. Guys, our ult is up. Our gunblade slows up. So this is a double kill. This is a double kill. I'm going to run back a little bit. Make them think that I'm not actually trying to kill them. And check this out. So a lot of the time they actually fall for it. Not this time, apparently. Anyways, guys, moving on. We have 1,000 gold. And the only good option right now is Sork Boots. Super insanely good. Guys, these items, Gunblade, Sork Boots, Zhonya's, and sometimes Oblivion Orb, so good on Akali. These are like the core items. This is when you're thriving. This is the mid-game Akali that wins games. She's not the best late game. She's not bad late game. But mid-game is when you need to win the game in order to like actually have a high win rate. So with that in mind, guys... We're just gonna kill them. We're just gonna kill them. Because we don't have priority, our jungle is 0 and 4, and their Pyke can get to us really quickly. With his W and boots of mobility, I need to be playing fights that I can win very quickly, or I know I won't die in, if we're outnumbered. We can definitely kill Pyke easily, even if Zac shows up, but we can't kill Zac if Pyke shows up. Because if we use our spells on a tank, then obviously Pyke will just shred us to pieces. So we're gonna have to be a little bit more careful moving forward. Alright guys, Pyke just went back, so we're going to shove the wave in really quick, and then we're going to look to roam. I'm even going to use W to get energy back to take the wave faster. And this is something that I'm expecting Pyke to be at, but hopefully... Okay, that's good. We're there, just in case we need to dive, but I think Pyke is on his way, so just back up. We see Pyke is bot lane, and the bot lane had just died. And the jungler's there. I'm not gonna help the jungler. You know, he's 1 in 5, but it's whatever. I'm gonna get 1,000 gold for my team here and just open up mid lane vision by taking it out. This is much more important than helping your jungler. Assuming you don't think they're gonna rage quit. Alright, hit him with the gunblade. And this should be a kill. Here we go. Had to use E. I don't want him to respawn and just fly away. I don't know how my Q missed him. That made no sense at all. Okay, what we're gonna do here, we're gonna ult over. We're actually gonna go for it. No auto, okay, 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 maybe. There we go, there we go. Okay, just a little late. Anyways guys, next up on the build, we got a Oblivion Orb. Now this is a very strong item you should pretty much always get. But the question is, do you upgrade it to a Morello? The answer is, it just depends on the enemy team comp. If they have healing, like this time I would. Zac, Blobs, and Darius Q is enough. Not to mention Pyke W. That's enough for me to want to do it. I'm gonna flash. That is unfortunate. Definitely a little greedy there, or very greedy rather, but it's okay. Oh my lord, this is so good. Well, we got one. If they chase, I'll bait it. I can definitely kill them. I'm just gonna leave it then. And now, honestly, I feel like because there's a big bot lane wave, they might actually send someone bot lane to clear it. So I'm gonna go ahead and wait here for a second. This is kind of like an intuition thing. Could not work out. They could be at dragon as well, which is also another reason why I'm here. Is once it spawns, if they go on it, I have a red plant to flank them. Doesn't look like they're on it though. This is a free kill. And that is a free kill. All you gotta do is look for them, and I see this guy. I'm gonna zone this while I have no cooldowns and while he's gonna try and Q me, and then we can keep going in. And that is a kill. Just know, the reason I zoned at that time is it's because it's a time where I would do the least amount of damage, and it's the time where I would take the most in exchange. It was the worst possible trade time for me, which is why I decided to go for it. Anyways, we're gonna take this out really quick. We gotta move to the future, not talk about the past. Right now, this is looking like a potential flank for us. And that is a flank for us indeed. And that is a lot of free kills, and 15 and 6 just like that, guys. Every new item is a different potential. Every new item gives you more new potential in the way you play the game. You just have to use your items smart. Don't Zonya's 2 damage. Zonya's 1,000,000 damage. And there you go. Guys, I think we're going to win here. No, we're not going to win yet. Just going to clear this wave and back up. We're actually in a very interesting spot gold-wise. We could go for Rabadon's because it would do the most against Jhin, Pyke, and Senna, which is pretty much all we're targeting anyways. But in terms of being like a team player, team fighter, I think Void would be better. But because all of their damage is, you know, Pyke, Jhin, and Senna, and Pyke has 15 kills, he's got half their kills, and he's melee, I will definitely go for a Rabadon's. We have the survivability off of the Zonya's and the Shroud. We don't really need anything else tanky. So yeah, this is probably the perfect build. We go Void Staff next. Eventually we'll sell the Oblivion Orb. But for now, this is it. All right, not bad poke. Okay. I pressed E. Should be fine here, just press E. Gonna run with him. Hey. Yep, he's dead. You gotta run with him. You do not want to let him get away by being too far out of the circle, but you gotta, you obviously you can just run inside the circle. That should be it. I'm gonna go ahead and just run with him. If I don't get minion blocked to death. Take this out. Two inhibs are now down. Nami with the intentional feed. All good though. Let's go ahead and cue this. We can heal up. Alright guys, this is probably the most important fight yet. It's for our... Okay. Please kill Zach. Do not let him take that. Okay. Well, that is the Cloud Soul, so we're good to go. Okay. There we go. Guys, I think it's over. I think it is finally over. I thought that was gonna be a lot harder, but apparently all it takes is them trying to steal our blue and then us destroying them. So we're gonna go ahead and end the game off of mid lane and we'll do the outro. Alright guys, so in conclusion, here's the thing about Akali, right? You play super aggressive, not because it's always gonna work out, but because you try to do your one for ones when it's necessary. You just try to learn and get better at the champion. Obviously, this was me playing hyper aggressive for a video, and it's not always gonna work out, but we did end up carrying the freaking Sanguine Blade Kha'Zix. We did a good job, and that's all that matters. Just practice playing aggressive. Never, ever be scared. If you think you have a chance of killing them, go for it. But if don't be dumb, obviously. Don't just feed like for no reason. Anyways, guys, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you want to see a top lane edition for this, be sure to leave a like and comment down below. Top. 5 tops in a row, and I'll do it. Guys, thank you so much for watching, and have a good day. Peace out.